New COVID-19 cases in South Korea top 100,000 for the first time amid an Omicron-fueled surge. The Korea Disease Control and Prevention Agency says, although infections are soaring to unprecedented levels, deaths have remained relatively low as South Korea is a highly vaccinated country. Authorities announced on Friday businesses can now extend their operating hours until 10 in the evening. However, other COVID measures will remain in place until at least March 13th. That's days after the March 9th presidential election. The quarantine period for COVID-exposed individuals can now be shortened in areas with high caseloads based on the new guidelines from the World Health Organization. The recommended quarantine of 14 days can be cut to 7 if the contact has no symptoms and presents a negative COVID test. But the WHO says the contact must still wear a face mask at all times and practice all the health protocols for the remainder of the 14 days. The UN agency says the latest guidance will be particularly helpful in places where essential services are under pressure. Israel will soon drop the requirement to show proof of COVID vaccination to enter various establishments, including bars, restaurants, hotels, and houses of worship. Prime Minister Naftali Bennett said with a clear decline in new infections there, it is a good time to scrap the so-called green pass. New cases have significantly gone down in Israel. From last month's over 80,000 new COVID cases per day, the number is now down to below 30,000. Canadian police have begun arresting protesters occupying central Ottawa. Among those put in handcuffs, one of the protesters' main fundraisers and organizers. Police officers have restricted access to downtown Ottawa. They also placed barriers around government buildings and distributed leaflets warning truck drivers of, quote, severe penalties. Similar threats of fines and jail time helped convince protesters to retreat earlier this week from 4 border points with the U.S. Truckers opposing vaccine mandates have blocked roads in the capital for nearly 3 weeks now. The movement has inspired similar protests in New Zealand, Australia, France, and Israel. Fears of Russia's imminent invasion of Ukraine renewed following an exchange of fire between Kyiv's forces and pro-Russian separatists. Russia also circulated a document at the United Nations Security Council alleging that war crimes had been committed in the southeastern portion of Ukraine. U.S. President Joe Biden says Moscow is only preparing a pretext to justify a possible attack. He adds Russia has also expelled U.S. Deputy Chief of Mission Bart Gorman. Biden is reportedly hosting a meeting on the Ukraine conflict with several world leaders this Friday.
They have not moved any of their troops out. They've moved more troops in, number one. Number two, we have reason to believe that they are engaged in a false flag operation to have an excuse to go in. Every indication we have is they're prepared to go into Ukraine, attack Ukraine.
Ukraine vowing to defend itself against any attack from Russia.
The Ukraine remains committed to peaceful resolution of the Russian-Ukrainian conflict by political diplomatic means. Ukraine wants peace, security, and stability, not only for itself, but also for the entire Europe. At the same time, I reiterate that in the event of Russia opting for escalation, Ukraine will defend itself.